How far have you ever driven a bass boat to fish in a tournament? 30 miles, 40 miles, 50 miles, 100? Good morning, guys and girls. This is going to be a great day out here today. We are getting ready to go fishing. Any day you get to go fishing is going to be absolutely fantastic. We got a bright southern sunshine shining down on us, January 17, and we're going to look at Psalms 37:3. This is really short. Y'all might memorize this just when I say it. Trust the Lord and do good. Trust the Lord and do good. That's it. That's the entire scripture. I finished third in a bass tournament on Lake Powell, Arizona. Fred Ward, that's a BASS tournament, on Lake Powell, Arizona. Fred Ward won. Larry Nixon was second, and he actually drew Fred Ward as a partner in that tournament. And we were all fishing, get this, 113 miles from takeoff and the weigh-in. 113 miles. Actually, we were going to a creek, and I was stopping at the 113-mile marker and turning up a creek and going a couple, 2 or 3 miles up that creek. So we were really further than that. We were going to the 113-mile marker. To travel 113 miles one way, putting a tremendous amount of trust in that big Black Mercury outboard on the back of my boat. Back in those days, we were running 150s, 150 horsepower. So think about that a minute. It wasn't these big, great things we have nowadays. By placing trust in that motor, I did well, we all did well, and we all prospered. No matter what, we can't fail when we place our trust in the God that created us. You hear what it says? We can't fail. We're not always going to prosper in everything we do. We'll falter, we'll fail at times, but I know this, I have victory and safety and prosperity in Jesus, regardless of what might go wrong today. This trust in Him will carry me safely through. Ponder on that for a little bit. Here comes our tip for the day. This is a good one because this time of the year, pretty much cold fronts coming through all the time. After a cold front, try a white Marabu Roadrunner or Stump Jumper jig. That's a little jig with a little spinner on it, with a fluorescent red head. White Marabu with a fluorescent red head. Now, why do we use Marabu after a cold front in the wintertime? One of the reasons is Marabu, if you'll wet it down real good when you put it in the water, Marabu will have really good action. So we want to use a Marabu, a fluorescent red head. And I'm not sure exactly why all of this is happening that way. I don't know why that is really the very best thing to use, but I've proven it over and over and over again. Kind of like the scripture we was reading right there, that I've proven this, I have victory just regardless of what might go wrong. You know, regardless of what might happen, that's the best color. And I've proven it over and over again. I found out kind of accidentally one time, fishing with Joe Hall on Lake Fort Gibson in Oklahoma. And we wasn't catching any fish at all. And we put, I think he might have put it on, a white Marabu with fluorescent red head. And we started catching fish. Obviously, I did it again the next time and the next time and the next time. That was probably 25 years ago. Hey, guys and girls, y'all have a great one out there today. I love you.